Pooja. First of all, let me thank PDG Krishnan Chittur. It was a very, very heartfelt delivery which he made just now. For me also, it was a great occasion to refresh my fundamentals of enterprise education. Thank you very much, Krishnan sir. He's from New York, but presently visiting India, and he took time off from some very urgent work which he had to be with us. Let me continue. I welcome once again all the people who are present over here, Rotarians, Rotaractors, teachers, parents, and youth. Special mention of people who are attending from outside of Maharashtra, like Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Jammu and Kashmir, and other countries like Nepal, Bangladesh, Pakistan, and USA. Thank you very much. Thanks to RID 3131 District Literacy Committee and Rotaract Club of Pune Urja for organizing this event. Today is a Teacher's Day, and in the Indian Express today, there was this particular article which said, "To our childhood friend, communicator, and healer, a happy Teacher's Day." I was surprised to read that, and so I thought of this particular prayer today, based on that. In Marathi, there is a verse which says, "Tulsi Maya Bahu Divya Hi Guni, Sada Poshite Jani Jivani, Ashi Bhavana Vani Lochani, Mama Sadguni Asudemani." So derived from this, I have tried to make a short prayer over here. I will be happy if you join me. O Mother Nature, amidst global concern in these trying times, we the attendees of this webinar pray to thee. Thou art resplendent with many a virtues of healing that give us good health in body, spirit, and mind. O Mother Nature, bless us.
That such healing
virtues be ensconced also in our own sight, thoughts, words, and deeds. For then alone shall we, the attendees, achieve for ourselves and the society much the same healing, good deeds. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Thank you very much for being with me in this. Sorry. Today's plan, the opening address was by Rotarian PDG Krishnan Chittur. He has summarized the entire process of entrepreneurship in very short points. I was counting them. There are almost 12, a dozen points. My focus is more on the activity part. So from the strategies, I'm coming down to the tactics. I'll be talking sometimes in Marathi. थोड़ा समय मराठी पण मध्ये मध्ये बोलणार आहे कारण काही आपले अध्यापक गण आहेत त्यांना मराठी मध्ये जास्त कम्फर्टेबल आहे पण माझा भर हा जास्त करून ऍक्टिव्हिटीजवर राहणार आहे म्हणजे कृती जी आपण करणार आहोत त्याच्यावरती तर त्याच्यामध्ये विल बी डुईंग मार्केटिंग प्लॅन डिझाईन प्लॅन अँड प्रोडक्शन प्लॅन माझ्यानंतर रोटेरियन श्याम अर्जुनवाडकर हे ह्या विषयावरती बोलतील फ्रॉम सायन्स टू इंडस्ट्रियल ऍप्लिकेशन अँड एंटरप्रेन्योर एक्सपिरियन्स वी नो दॅट द ग्लोबल क्राइसिस ऑफ कोरोना has led to shrinking economic sectors and rising unemployment. This has led to need to reimagine education and skills. You may be aware that India's GDP for the first quarter of 2019-20 was about 3,500,000 crores. It has shrunk to 2,600,000 crores by almost 25%. When GDP shrinks, unemployment also takes place. Almost unemployment has also increased by about 25% in our country. Is this a problem? Partly it's a problem, but also it's an opportunity for the youth like you who are now coming forward. आपल्या देशाची जी जीडीपी जी म्हणतात ती कमी झालेली आहे पण त्याच्यामुळे आपल्याला नवीन संधी निर्माण झालेल्या आहेत. A well engaged youth is a healthy condition for peace in the society. And the new education policy in fact talks about making job creators instead of job seekers out of our youth. This is where enterprise education comes in. This enterprise education, as Subodh Malpaniji said, provides a vision to provide an opportunity for every school going child and college going youth to develop an enterprising mindset. After you do enterprise education, it is not expected that all of you will suddenly become big entrepreneurs and big businessmen. You could be intrapreneurs, that is, wherever you are employed, you are still enterprising. You could be entrepreneurs of your own enterprises. Or you could be motivators for school children and youth, motivators like me. आपल्यापैकी जे टीचर्स आहेत त्या सगळ्यांनी शालेय विद्यार्थ्यांसाठी तुमच्या विद्यार्थ्यांसाठी मोटिवेटर्स बनलं पाहिजे, त्यांना उत्सुक बनवलं पाहिजे एंटरप्राइज एज्युकेशनच्या प्रती आणि स्वतःचा छोटा मोठा उद्योग करण्याकरता. बिफोर आय फॉरगेट लेट मी मेन्शन दॅट देर आर गोइंग टू वॉक इन ट्युटोरियल स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम मंडे टिल फ्रायडे 11:30 AM to 12:30 PM and again on Wednesday and Thursday 9th and 10th September 4 PM to 5 PM depending on the requirement. You have to inform me on WhatsApp if you want to come. आपण वॉक इन ट्युटोरियल्स घेणार आहोत तुमच्या सगळ्यांसाठी 7 ते 11 सप्टेंबर पर्यंत, 11:30 ते 12:30 आणि 9 आणि 10 सप्टेंबरला 4 ते 5 प्रोव्हाइडेड तुम्ही मला व्हॉट्सअप वरती कळवाल. तर ते कशा करता की वी आर गोइंग टू बी व्हेरी फास्ट इन व्हॉट वी आर टॉकिंग टुडे इन द नेक्स्ट 30-40 मिनिट्स. नॉर्मली व्हॉट आय एम गोइंग टू टॉक इज टॉट इन 3 इंडिपेंडेंट कोर्सेस ओव्हर अ टर्म. सो आय एम ओनली गोइंग टू ओपन अ डोर, मी फक्त एक दरवाजा उघडणार आहे तुमच्यासाठी आणि आय विल बी रिफरिंग यू टू द टीचिंग मटेरियल विच वी आर मेकिंग अवेलेबल फॉर यू थ्रू विच यू कॅन कंटिन्यू युअर स्टडीज. आणि ह्या ट्युटोरियल मध्ये आय विल बी फोकसिंग ऑन वर्कशीट्स टू हेल्प यू कम्प्लीट द वर्कशीट्स. जस्ट ऍज अ रिकॅप, इन द अर्लियर वेबिनार्स वी हॅड टॉक्ड ऑफ द 3 आवर्स ऑफ कन्व्हेन्शनल लिटरसी अँड विथ दॅट वी हॅड कम्पेअर्ड व्हॉट आर द 3 आवर्स ऑफ एंटरप्राइज लिटरसी. सो फर्स्ट आवर वॉज रीड द रिटन वर्ड अगेन्स्ट विच वी हॅव रीड द माइंड्स ऑफ द पीपल. सेकंड आवर वॉज write the written word against which in enterprise literacy we have read, write the plans creatively. And what are those plans? So those are design plans, marketing plan, production plan and finance plan and global trade plan and business plan. So today we are going to very briefly touch upon these 3 plans, design, marketing and production, within the time available to you. And after my just this very very small introduction, I would request you to go to the website enterprise-education.in, Rupa Karun tya website varti ja and tithe tumhala baki sagli mahiti milel, sagle lessons milatil, tyacha secondary, higher secondary and college he sections jasta baga. Look at the secondary, higher secondary, college. In that also you can look at the general and business studies of the secondary, higher secondary. Ani tyanantar marathi madhe udyog sadhana navi vatsal navache 27 videos ahet jyachyamadhe pratyek lesson shikavla gelela ahe. You can do a search for Udyog Sadhana Navi Vatsal on YouTube and find 27 videos in Marathi where every single lesson of enterprise education has been taught. So these are the 2 resource materials which we will refer to you now. The first lesson is marketing. What I suggest is when we are continuing, since I'm going very fast, feel free to talk on the chat box. I'll be looking at the chat box if you have any questions, if you have any remarks, if you have any suggestions. And when I pose some question to you, if you have your answers, please put them into the chat box. Marketing karta ek sundar sutra hai, bazar peth grahak olkhun, vastu vivaran mulya vitran tharvun, vignyapanane laksha vedun, vipanan sadhave. Very short, in 4 lines, it talks about marketing. For an identified customer segment, when one makes the decision of product, price, place and promotion, that is marketing introduction. Please remember those 4 words, product, price, place, and promotion. Because we are going to use that again. The key objective of the marketing module, which is there on the website, is to introduce you to this product, price, place, promotion concept and help you to make a marketing plan for your own business. There are various concepts and skills which are discussed in each lesson. In this particular lesson, the concepts talked about are marketing, advertising, competition, free market, retailer, wholesaler, brand, and market research. I will only spend a little time on market research. What exactly is your understanding of market research? Can you just put it on the chat box in a sentence? Tumhala market research, that's it. या शब्दांचं काय समजत? कॅन समबडी ट्राय टू पुट समथिंग ऑन द चॅट बॉक्स प्लीज, देन आय विल नो व्हॉट इज ट्रेंडिंग. व्हेरी गुड मुविन, थँक्यू व्हेरी मच. फिरोज जी, व्हेरी वेल सेट. व्हॉट इज ट्रेंडिंग? सर्चिंग कॉम्पिटिटिव्ह प्रोडक्ट अँड रेलेवंट कस्टमर बेस. व्हॉट सेल्स? व्हेरी गुड. सर्वेइंग ह्युमन बिहेवियर ऑल्सो. नाईस. ओके. Analysis of goods. Excellent, excellent. Okay, friends, I can tell you, you guys are putting the finger on that point and very well explaining it. Thank you very much for having participated in this. Good. Keep on thinking, very good. In every lesson, we'll also talk about enterprise skills. So in this particular lesson, when you see on the website, you will find critical thinking, formulating questions, negotiation, designing a questionnaire, compiling and analyzing, competitiveness and persuasiveness. So I will not go into each of them because it can take time. You can get all these definitions on the lesson, and in the tutorials we can have a detailed discussion if you want to ask any particular questions. Okay, here is a sample of a market research questionnaire. This is a market research sample for electrical appliances. I had also done a similar market research for electrical batteries. So it gives the name of the person, sex, age, address. Have you purchased any electrical appliances in last 6 months? Yes or no? Which appliances did you take? This. Where did you buy? You know, and this way it is. Now, when I did my market research, I went from door to door gathering the information of whatever was of interest to me. I went from door to door. Now, what I would like you to do is, in the last two webinars, we have already discussed what is your own business idea. I think most of you must have come to a particular business idea in your mind. I would like you to design a market survey questionnaire for your particular product now. Do it for your own product. But the question which is more relevant to me just now is, for after you have designed your market survey questionnaire, given the current coronavirus or even future situations, how will you conduct your market research? How will you conduct? I had gone door to door. I had gone shop to shop. I remember I went on our Lakshmi Road. Then I went on Pasudaya Vithap, that area of Pune. I went from shop to shop making my market survey. But now I cannot do it. It's not permitted. How can you conduct any market survey now? Can somebody name? Yes, online. Anita Colgott, very good. E-marketing. I have not yet come to marketing. I'm still at market research. How will I do a market research? I've designed my questionnaire. How will I submit it to my friends, to my two other unknown people? What will I do? Preparing? Yeah, Google form. Ranu, thank you for that suggestion. Yes, Google form is a very good thing. Social media is very good. You can ask the same question on Facebook, social handles. Yes. Put your surveys online where people can go mostly. Yes. Sending G-Docs. Okay. And put it on the website. Excellent. Excellent answers. Facebook post. Right. Very good. In fact, just some days back for our this webinar also, we had circulated a Google form to find out who is interested. And then we had given certain questions, which is this timing suits you, this, that, and all. And people had answered. That is how we did our market survey. Right? Thank you very much. You got it right. You got it on the dot. So please go ahead. You already have your thoughts clear. Prepare your own market questionnaire. And right now, do it at least for the sake of practice. It's a great fun doing a market survey. After you have done your market survey, bring it to the tutorial. I'll help you how to analyze it. Now the next exercise. Before I forget, you may be Haryana Mahita Sim. तुम्हाला असे एक वर्कशीट्स पाठवले गेलेले आहेत असे वाले वर्कशीट्स हैव बीन सेंड टू यू ऑन ईमेल लाइक दिस प्लीज डाउनलोड देम व्हाट एवर एक्टिविटी आई एम रेफरिंग टू यू आर डन ओवर देयर आर अवेलेबल ओवर देयर फॉर यू टू सॉल्व कैन टेक अ प्रिंट आउट और फिल इट इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट अ रियल ट्रू स्टोरी ऑफ पुणे देयर इज अ फ्रेंड आई नो हिज नेम इज अभिजीत वेरी ट्रू स्टोरी आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू So Abhijit, when he was in school, just growing up, he used to always wonder what I will do when I grow up. It's the same question which all of you might be having now. What will I do? He was very good at tinkering with electronic things. He used to like it a lot. So his parents, teachers, you know, they used to say, "Arey, you will be a very good electronic person." So what he did was he underwent a course in electronic repairs. He did not do a full-fledged this thing. Degree course, just a repairing course. And then he has started in Pune, a small shop, electronic repair shop. It's still there. But Abhijit is a bit poor in marketing. And that is where he is looking for help. So he asked me, can your participants help me? I said, okay, let me try. So here is the worksheet for Abhijit's marketing plan. The questions which you have to help Abhijit answer is, what is the product or service Abhijit has to promote or sell? What factors should Abhijit consider when pricing his product or service? This is a very dicey question, because whenever we talk of a particular service especially, we very easily take care of the raw materials and elements, components that go into it. But what do we miss out? Can somebody tell me what is missed out in pricing normally? Try and give an answer. There's one particular cost component that often gets missed out. Labor cost, right. Thank you, Varad Deshpande. Very well said. Labor cost is what gets missed out. Very often the person does not cost price his own services into it. Suppose I take, let's say, 3 hours to repair a phone. Then I must cost price into it what I cost, what is my price. And invisible cost also. Julia, what are invisible cost? Gangwani, what is the invisible cost? I'm myself not clear. If you can just write over there. Okay, comparative price of the product. Okay, Sunita ji, thank you very much. Good. Costing depends on good and how much is demanding. Okay, sometimes. That is pricing. That means depending on the demand, what the price should be. Costing is more based on the actual cost of the procurement of raw material, what you put as a labor cost and the invisible cost. Invisible cost, I believe what you mean is the utilities, that's electricity, rent, etc. Thank you. I think that should be good enough. Then there are two more questions over there. How Abhijit should ensure that the customers come to his place of business and how he will promote his business. Spend your own time, take your own time and do it. Then we are talking of designing. Then we are talking of designing. This is the second plan which we talked about in writing your own plans. Under designing, we have another sutra, I might call it, or mantra if you like to call it. Yantriki udyogacha vichar prashikshan anubhavane karava sakar kiwa tantragnyan hastantara avlamboni. Science and engineering ventures with experience and education you could make, or through technology transfer successfully oneself take. In this lesson, if you go on the website is always repeated here, enterprise-education.in. Please do visit it. There are concepts of designing, of taking the idea to product or service, prototype making, design information, quality, reliability. And in skills, there is problem solving, record keeping, integrating information and documentation. Just I want to spend 15-20 seconds on design information. There are clues given over there, but what is your understanding of design information? What would be your understanding of design information? Okay, never mind. It's a difficult question. We will understand it more by an example. But let me first tell you that a good design has to be appropriate and achievable. Appropriate means it should suit the purpose for which we are designing. And achievable means after you design it, you should be able to produce it or manufacture it or replicate it. This is how a design process flowchart looks. If you see from the top, you start here. You have a business idea or you have a product idea. So you gather the design information and integrate. What this design information is, you will soon see in the next example. You make a prototype, that means a sample. Test for quality and reliability of that prototype, this stage. Then check if that design which you have made is appropriate and achievable. If it is appropriate, then make a record of whatever you have done. Because otherwise, when you pass it on to a manufacturing line, they won't know what you have done. And then go into production. But if it is not fulfilling your objectives, then you have to do problem solving, solve that problem, and again go back to the prototype stage. So this is the plan, how you have a design plan. Now to understand design information, this is a design information record chart which has been made here for cricket balls. Remember one thing, that whatever we do here is on a very simplified level, for the simple reason that it is directed from school children to college youth. So, but don't get disturbed by अरे इतना simple क्या है ये. It is simple because it is designed like that. अध्यापकांना सांगावं असं वाटतं की हे उदाहरण खूप सोपी वाटतात कारण ते शाळेच्या मुलांसाठी डिझाईन आहेत. तर तुम्ही त्याच्यातनं फक्त फंडामेंटल्स क्लिअर करून घ्या अँड देन यू गो ऑन टू युअर ओन डिझाईन इन्फॉर्मेशन चार्ट. सो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ क्रिकेट बॉल्स विच यू कॅन मेक. वन इज आयदर ऑफ प्लास्टिक अदर अदर इज लेदर. यू आर ट्राइंग टू फर्स्ट गेट डिझाईन इन्फॉर्मेशन. सो द क्वेश्चन्स फॉर अप्रोप्रिएटनेस, इज द मटेरियल स्ट्रॉंग इनफ, सेज प्लास्टिक नो, लेदर येस. Is it good looking? Yes, plastic also good looking, leather balls also good looking. Reliability, will it last 50 overs? Now you can take a call. What do you think? Will a plastic ball last 50 overs? What do you think? Yes or no? No, yeah. It will obviously not last. Thank you. Can't say. Okay. Nishant, thank you. Then there are other questions. Is it cheap? Is it safe to manufacture? Is it safe for player? Now these are not the only questions. It depends on what designing you are making. So you'll have to formulate your own questions and then accordingly gather the design information. Then the second part is achievable. Do you have people, that is men, with the skills to make or design? Then can you design in a reasonable time, and do you have place for the storage and manufacturing? Are the materials and tools available, and so many others. So you have to list down all your question of achievable and try to answer them and put that data together. That is called design information. Once the design information is ready, then you are ready to make your own design plan. So now can you please do a design information chart for whatever business idea you had in mind over the last two webinars. Make your own design plan the way it is shown over here. Thank you very much. Now we are at the now suddenly you will find that from one lesson I have skipped to shifted to the next one, which is production. So once you have done a market research, come upon, decided your product idea, designed it, now you come to the production part of it. So let us spend some time on this. Here the guiding mantra is kachya malache parivartan yasa manti utpadana nirmana paddhati sansadhana niyojit karave. Conversion of raw material, no ye, is production called. Methods, processes, resources have to be well controlled. So this summarizes, see that methods, processes, resources, these are three very key words over there. Please remember that. Methods, processes and resources have to be well controlled. Under this lesson, when you go to the website, you will find concepts of production, which is manufacturing, assembling or creating something useful. Production process or system, which is an organized procedure for conversion of inputs into outputs, and of course your enterprise idea. And the skills, we have assembling the products through various processes like riveting, soldering, fastening, and very importantly, discipline in production, where you have to stick to your schedules and deadlines. Now here, I would like you to answer this. I'm going to quickly show you a few examples of enterprises. Which ones do you see over here in this first slide, on the left and the right? You can put both the answers in one time. What are the two enterprises over here? Yes, somebody, can you? Okay, security and chef. Very correct. Security and catering. Very good. On the dot. On the dot. Security. Cyber security also is a good one. I had not thought of that. Security and food. Okay, very right. Now remember these two examples and look at the pictures very carefully, because I'm going to ask you to identify what are the common elements in these pictures. This is the second one. What is on the left and what is on the right? Okay, factory. Both are factories. Very good. Both are factories. Welders and laborers. Machines. Remember that word, huh? Who said that? Julia. Remember that. Machines. Tailors. Production setup. Kavita. Okay. Good one. Okay, that should be good. Remember these two pictures now. Next. What is this? What is this picture? IT. IT, call center, IT, labs, okay, good. Fine, fine, call center, IT or customer care solutions and sell, good. Good, I think most of you have got it, BPO. Now, here I am trying to summarize what you saw. In each of those processes of production, there was something that went as an input, something that was a conversion process, and you got an output. That is a basic production fundamental. That means there were some elements which went in, there was a transformation which was done, and a useful material came out. One example I'm putting over here, what is the input here? Is it material? Is it data? Is it energy? I'm talking of human energy over here. What is the input here? Raw materials, right. Sangeeta, thank you. Raw materials is a very good answer. Okay, efforts, Momin, we will come to later. Okay, materials is the input. And how is the transformation being done? Is there a magic wand by which he's doing the transformation? How is he doing? Energy, okay. What else? There's something very, very popular, prominent in that picture, which he's using to transform the material which is lying on his right in blue. Machines, right. Very good. Machines are being used. Machines and tools. I like that answer. I like that answer because tools normally get forgotten. You get a machine, but you forget its tools. Machines and tools. Very good. Very good. Okay. We'll see the next one now. Very good. This one. What is the input? Is it material? Is it data? Is it energy? Is it, what is it? Data. Right. And what is the transformation process here? What is the transformation process? This is a slightly tricky question though. Communication, okay, that's good. Data communication is possible. But, okay. Solution, but use of machine, okay. Interacting, good. Good, good. Fairly good, fairly good, fairly good. Okay. Education also online, okay. Right. But basically, most of the, you are right, the input is data. Usually through such setups, we do an interpretation of that data in order to give an output of knowledge or information or some useful output like that. Now the last one. What is this input? Is it a material, data, energy, human energy I'm talking? Okay, vegetables, right, fruits. That is one data, it's raw material. I'm asking about something else now. Experience, yes. One word I'm still looking for. How is the transformation of that human effort done? Ah, skill. Who is that? Sorali. Yes. There is a certain skill that is needed to transform that energy, human energy, into a useful output. Here it is a culinary skill which is used to get an output of food services. All the input side, whatever you're getting, is called variable costs because it depends on what kind of a quantity you are planning. The conversion process or transformation, whatever we talked about, machines or interpretation or the skill set which the chef has developed, that is all fixed cost because one time you incur it. And then you get the various types of outputs. That is a product or service. So this is the thing. Materials, through machines, you make them products. Data, through interpretation, you make it knowledge. Energy through skills, you convert it into services. In short, variable costs through transformation through a fixed cost becomes your revenue. This is in short the summary of production. Is it okay with you? Are you clear about it? Yes or no? Yes, thank you very much, Krishma. Now I come, so let me now ask you that question, the trick question which I had in mind. What was common in those three, in all the pictures of enterprise which you saw? There are three M's of a production plan. Some of you would know it. Those are MBS. Okay, method is good. M is M for method. M for method. Machine, machine. Machine is a new word in it. Material, yes. M for material. M for manufacture, okay. M for money. M for marketing. Manpower. Okay, I was looking for that word, manpower. Okay? So let's see. Normally, when we talk of three M's of production, we say men or women, first M, machines, that is tools, equipment, and machinery, and materials, raw materials, and components. That is how normally we summarize. But your other efforts are also very much in the right direction. Now I'm going to play a small game with you. I said somewhere that production, once you decide, once you have done your market survey, fix up your product or a service, made a good design plan, then you come to a point where you have to do a production process. So I'm going to play a game of fastest finger first, like Amitabh Bachchan used to play. Are you ready for it? Okay. I'm going to show you something of ball pen manufacturing, very simple process. I'll have to stop this sharing and share something else. Okay. Give me a minute. Yeah, I think it has shown up, right? Okay. Now, this is a manufacturing process. I am a manufacturing operator, and my entrepreneur is trying to tell you what to do. So he said, click the, okay. Okay.
And drop the spring in front of the refill.
So I says, he says, drag and drop the spring. That's what my entrepreneur is telling me.
Drag and drop the barrel in front of the refill.
Okay.
Drag and drop the ring at back of the refill.
Okay, this is the next step, yep.
Drag and drop the cap at back of the refill.
Okay, here it is. The ball pen is ready.
Reset button,
okay,
to redo the activity.
Did you follow it? Okay. Here you're shown. What happened? Okay. The jumbled up process is given here. A, it says assemble the cap at back of the refill. B, assemble the spring in front of the refill. C, assemble the ring at the back of the refill. And D, assemble the barrel in front of the refill. You have to rearrange them in the correct order. Huh? Okay, what is Priti said? B, C, A, C, D, like one. Priti says B, D, C, A. Another fellow says B, D, A, C, that is Nishant. Sangeeta says B, D, C, A. Spring barrel ring cap. Good, okay, that also will do. B, D, C, A. Good, good, good. BDAC. Tanishka, just think it over again. BDAC. Kavita, BDCA. Okay. C3A4. Okay. BCA. Okay, most of you have got it right. BDCA. You're right. You're right. Okay. So the order is assemble the spring in front of the refill. Then the barrel in front of the refill, ring at back of the refill, and cap at back of the refill. Now my question to you is as follows. Why do we at all need such a documented production process in any enterprise? Is it related to the type of men we have, and in what way? Why do we at all need all this? Why? Yes? Consistency, you're right, consistency. New men can learn, yes, to save time. Method, you set up a method for it, right? Less efforts, okay, time saving. Good, good, it's a good indication. Speed up the process, yeah. Basically, it is to be able to train the labor under you to do what you want. See, you as an entrepreneur know the process by heart because you have designed the whole product. You have got all its material. The whole process is with you. But how do you transfer it? So to transfer it, it has to be documented very perfectly and given to the people. The second question is, How is why is it this document needed? Sorry, is it related to material and in what way? The knowledge transfer was a good one, Momin. Why is a documented production process needed? Is it related to material in what way? Yes, related to material, Preeti, but in what way? Why do I need to do this knowledge transfer through a document? Cost. Cost is a good point. Cost is a good point. Yes. Quality and quantity. That's the perfect answer. Soham Bobde, very good. Quality and quantity. So it is to ensure that the right quality of product will come out at the end. Then we'll go to the next one. Is it related to the machines and in what way? In this pen manufacturer, the machines were not there. But sometimes production process also needs machines. Yes, accuracy. Okay, that's a good one. Maintaining. Yes, how do you maintain the machines if you buy them? Yes. What else? Are the machines appropriate? Are they safe to use? Okay, very good, very good. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now the last question. Is it related to the scale of production? Is it related to the scale of production? How? Why? So you see in this picture, on the first is a single perhaps the entrepreneur herself who's stitching the garment, and then she has her thing has expanded, and now she has got 100 girls working for her. So what happens? Can she stand in front of everybody and keep on telling, okay, this is a process? No, she has to give a particular production process and distribute it to all of them, so that each one of them will do the same thing. You see in the right picture, material is same, machine is same, all of them have the same thread. They will make sure that all of them make the same design of the garment. So it's a general guideline, as you are saying, and it's a fast teaching and easy learning. Thank you very much for those inputs. To keep the proper ratio or proportions and same guidelines. So that is why we need a documented production process. So I think most of you are now ready. So now you can make your own production plan. In the worksheet, it will help you. Please find out what is your requirement of labor, what is your requirement of materials, what is your requirement of machinery, and make your own production plan. Why are we doing all this? Because in the final tutorial webinar, which we will do on the 19th, we are going to take a business plan competition. And in the business plan competition, I'm calling it a preliminary business plan, not a final business plan. We would like you to focus on four types of plans. One is your marketing plan, which is governed by the four P's. Then your design plan of two A's and your production plan with the details of men, machines and material. So these three are now told to you. Please look at the lessons which are there on the website, also in the video films. And then start preparing your business plan. And I will be there to help you throughout the week, starting from Monday. Anytime you want, it's a walk-in tutorial, walk-in anytime you want, I'll be sending the link to all of you. The last one which is left is finance plan, that we will be doing in the next webinar. And then you can submit your business plans. So my teaching is finished now. Important announcements, there'll be two more teaching webinars. All the worksheets which are with you, please submit them at the email address that is given over here, pradeepwag.rotary@gmail.com. If you submit 50% of them, you will get a certificate of enterprise education. Important announcement is that the last webinar is preliminary business plan competition. First prize is rupees 10,000, sponsored by Cubix Tech Rotary and Nitin Naik. Second prize is rupees 5,000, sponsored by my NGO, Development Education International Society. The next webinars are scheduled on 12th September, 3:30 p.m. to 5 p.m. and 19th September, which is the grand finale. What we will be doing is that from now you start preparing your business plan. We will give it a finishing touch on 12th September with the last module. And then we'll in the week after that, we will take elimination rounds. And finally, we will shortlist about three or four who will finally present to the experts, national level experts on 19th of September. So this here the walk-in tutorial details are given. Do attend if you like. These are purely optional and no registration, no specific time, 11:30 to 12:30, just walk in.
and you'll be attended to. Send all your worksheets and feedback to at my email over here, given over here. I am going to start a polling now, which you can please answer to till the end. I hand the session back to Director Pooja. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Our next speaker, please wait for him. He's a wonderful speaker, a very experienced speaker. So Pooja, over to you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.